Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved one, today is a beautiful Wednesday, being the 23rd day of June, and week 12 of ordinary time in the church calendar. Our readings will be coming from Genesis chapter 15, verse 1 to 12. Our response to Psalm will come from Psalm 105, verse 8a. A gospel message will come from Matthew Gospel chapter 7, verse 15 to 20. The theme of our message today is, you will know them by their fruits. You will know them by their fruits. Today is Jesus making us to be aware of false prophets who parade themselves as sheep outwardly, but inwardly. The ravageous wolves. Be careful about them. McQuaid was saying the words, and how do we know them? How do we know them? He said, Jesus said, look, you will know them by their fruits. By their fruits, you will know them. You know every tree, fruit tree, by his fruit. You will know a very good fruit tree by his fruit. So somebody's conduct and his will tell you whom he is. Or she is. By their fruits, you should know them. The way they dress, the way they talk, the way they live, the way they think, will tell you who they are. And Jesus began to tell us to make it obvious for all of us too that we don't pretend you don't know any person. He said, look, you can't pick grape from thorns. You cannot talk about gathering figs. Contestors. He said, let it be clear. Every sound tree will produce sound fruit. And every bad tree will produce bad fruit. It's clear. You can only pretend for people who are not on the ground. And he said, since you know now that bad trees produce bad fruits and good trees produce good fruits, you cannot be otherwise. He said, by their fruits, you should know them. You don't need any person to tell you a good governor and a good president. The result of your administration will tell you who they are. You don't expect a bad governor to produce good governance. If you're a good governor, you will see that people come to you for solutions and they offer the solution. You know it. But if you're a bad governor, if you're a bad governor or a bad president of any place, you become a terror to the people. You will not give them job. You will not build their roads. You will not bring development. Like that you bring terrorists to them like Hesmen and Boko Haram. Like that you turn the government parastatus that's supposed to care for the people to be against the people. As the army is now killing the people. Police is intimidating the people. No more serving the people. They can't protect the people because they're bad fruits. From bad tree. So you don't need to tell us you don't know. When you see a bad person, no person will tell you because no sooner he will radiate what is inside him. He will yield the fruit, you will see. He can only pretend for a while, but you soon will manifest the inner thing in him or her. Give her a little time. Give her a little test, she will manifest. So when you see you are parading on this society and pretending you are this and that, you are pretending for people who are not on the ground with you, who don't know the good truth and bad fruit. Who can separate between the two? And Jesus wants us to be aware about them. If Jesus can warn you, he will tell you how dangerous they can be. And that's why sometimes you see people who are crafty and consistent minds. They bring good fruits and join bad fruit with it so as to market both of them as good fruit, missing evil and good, to market them as good. They can bring one good man into governance and then bring all the criminals around him. They will just use that one to confuse the people. All those ones are window dressing for people who are not aware of what is happening around them. So bad governance, bad fruit. And bad tree produce bad fruit. Bad governor produce bad fruit. Bad president produce bad fruit. Bad father produce bad fruit. Bad mother produce bad fruit. Children. And so on and so forth, mention it. It's a litmus test for all of us. By your fruits you shall know them. A teacher was once telling Parents Association that you don't need to see you to know how your house is. Make sure your child will read everything that is your house. A dirty child is a sign of a dirty home. A careless child is a child of a careless home. A lousy child is a sign of a lousy home. Just see a child and you know the parents. Simple. By their fruits, you shall know them. So when the teacher was telling the parents, many of them were shocked by his revelation. We don't need to see you to know you. We will see your child, we know you. When you see a child who is making noise in the church, and when there is prayer going on, because they don't pray in his house, in their house. If they have been praying in their house, and he'll be keeping quiet when they were praying, he will call you when you come to the church, he will keep quiet. But when you see a noisy child in the church, in anywhere, it's a sign that he lives in a noisy environment, an organized environment. They don't pray in the house. So that's the implication for some of being the fruits and that and that. Funny side about it, when you see people who see bad tree and begin to say it's good tree, that is a piece of dishonesty. When you see bad people, you say they're good people. You are part of him. You want to deceive people so that they won't know whom he is. It's not like when you stay in Nigeria and see people talking that one Nigeria. That's the mark, that's the apex of a dishonest, conceited mind. Your fruit is already showing that you don't believe in one Nigeria and you are talking about one Nigeria. You don't even believe in unity and you are talking about unity. You don't believe in love and they are talking about love. You are dishonest. You are a crimes of dishonesty. It's because you see people in government. And people who are telling you the unity of the country cannot be compromised. These are the highest criminals you have in the country. Are the highest criminals you have in the country. And you can't even leave your village to other people's other village. Because you are afraid, because you know you are evil. What you have been doing to people in your village, you are afraid they will do in your village. That's why you don't leave your town to any other place. Because you don't accept strangers in your place, you believe you will not be accepted anywhere. That's why you don't go anywhere. Because you don't trust any person, that's why you believe you should not be trusted anywhere. And that's why when you're a tribalist, you can't even afford to accommodate another person because that's how your fruit is. You can't produce any better than that. A tribal tree will produce a tribal fruit. A barbaric tree will produce a barbaric people. And that's how you see it all over the place. You can't expect a barbarian to be talking about unity of different nations. It's not possible. You don't expect a tribalist to be thinking sincerely about the unity of the nations because he doesn't know it. He doesn't understand it. He can't even live it. You need a big-hearted man, a citizen, according to the Greek state of nations, to be able to produce the fruit of unity. Loving each other, loving people, speaking their language, staying with them anywhere, building in their places, farming with them, doing everything they are doing together with them. You find yourself as part of them. That's the best. Any person who could do that is a citizen. When you cannot do that, you're either a barbarian or a tribalist. You're a battery. Can give you good fruit of unity. And that's why today you can see Abraham himself showing the fruit of a child of God. And God was telling him that he will bless him, he will do everything. But Abraham said, look, Lord, you will talk about blessing me and doing things for me. But I'm going to still go on childless. Still going on childless. A slave in my house will now inherit my property, will be my heir. And God said, Abraham, no. A slave will not be the heir in your house. Your wife will be born and be a son and call him Isaac. He will be the person in the house. He will be the person to inherit your property. And he showed Abraham a lot of land where they will occupy. Abraham said, am I sure? And he went into a covenant to Abraham. And when we're told that Abraham was told that a son would be born to him, even at his old age, he believed. One of the characters of a child of God is believing God. Doesn't doubt God. Anyone who accepts this word and believes in it is given the privilege of being a child. This was recorded for Abraham as righteousness, for believing God, even in face of every scientific thing that is not true. But he believed God, knowing that God is God of impossibilities. An unsung God, within nothing is impossible. Abraham believed God and recorded for him as righteousness. And when God went into covenant with Abraham and took the fire to consume this act of the covenant. And it was a covenant between Abraham and his descendant that he would possess that land forever. So Abraham manifested the fruit of a person who comes from a very good foundation in God. If you are in God, you manifest the act of God. One of the signs that you are in God is that you are keeping the word of God. You believe God. 1 John chapter 2, verse 3 says, anyone who says, I know him, I believe in him, but doesn't keep the word of God, there is no truth in you. You're a wolf. But anyone who hears the word of God and keep it and live out this word is a child of God. He's bearing the proper fruit. And that word is something we want to see this so well today, this year. The Lord remember his covenant forever. God is ever faithful. He cannot deceive. He's a good God. He's a holy God. He's ever faithful. He cannot be unfaithful. We can be unfaithful, but he's not unfaithful. He's a good God. He cannot be a bad God. All his fruits are good. And if you are in him, you produce equally good fruit. If you are not in him, you produce bad fruits. Abraham was in him and producing good fruit. Of faith in God, of hope in God, of loving God. That's the fruit of people who are in God. I'm the true vine, you are my branches, and you can't be a branch of a good tree and eat bad fruit. You can't be a branch of a bad tree and eat good fruit. No, we are branch of the living God, true vine. And where do we produce fruit in abundance and good fruit for that matter? That glorifies God, that brings salvation to others. So he remembers his covenant he made with us. He made a covenant with us in baptism, made a covenant in us in the Eucharist, made a covenant with you in marriage, that he will be your God and you will be his own people. May God help us to keep to this tree, the good tree, and eat the good fruit. We are never part of bad tree, so we can have no reason to eat bad fruits. May God help us to understand this and we eat the appropriate fruit and avoid people who are blessings. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us. I will celebrate being part of the tree that is good fruit. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.